In the small town of Buda, Texas, these women are creating something new, using pieces from their past.
This transformative process of turning clothing into paper, usually people don't believe it, you know, and so it's this magical process that they get to be part of, and I always say it's kind of like alchemy.
Military uniforms, hats, headscarves, cut up, washed, and pulverized into a pulp. Pulp that's either pressed into paper or used to make these paintings.
It's about releasing that pain. It's about liberating and, through connection, building something beautiful from something that was traumatic.
It's called Project Raha, after the Dari word for release. The Afghans here served in the Afghan National Army's female tactical platoon, deploying with American special forces to collect intelligence in areas men couldn't. Some of these women even served together in Afghanistan. That is, until the Taliban took over 2 years ago this month.
That whole evacuation was, it was a mess. I think a lot of us felt really helpless. Like, it felt like something that was so close to our hearts, a culture and people that we loved and cared about. We were watching things just fall apart in a matter of days and hours.
Army veteran Sarah Scully worked with the female tactical platoon from 2019 to 2020. When Kabul fell, she and other military women helped get their Afghan counterparts out of the country. It's a time that's painful for the commandos to talk about.
We lost our dream, we lost our goals, we lost everything. Everything was like changed in one day, everything.
After 2 years, almost all of the nearly 40 female commandos who came to the United States remain in legal limbo, stuck in a backlog of asylum applicants.
They're from a country that being a woman in the military was like putting a target on your back. And the fact that some of these women still do not have asylum and some of them still have their futures up in the air, and there's a big question mark of what's next, is an injustice.
Hassani says she wants to know that she and her family will be safe, away from the Taliban's reach. She spent her whole life wanting to be in the Afghan military, a dream the Taliban took away. She now wants to join the U.S. Army, but she can't without a green card.
I know I'm losing the time. If I get older, I couldn't join to army and couldn't to follow my childhood dream.
Piece by piece, they place their loss, love, and hope onto canvas. The Veterans Support Group Command Purpose will display their work in a New York art gallery in November to raise money and awareness. Hassani's favorite piece that she created is a tribute to the Afghan army and Afghan flag.
Afghanistan is everything. Afghanistan is my heart.
Trauma transformed. Old made new. One art piece at a time. Carla Babb, VOA News.